children's book author lived isolated in the mountains. She loved roses. Once, she even won an award for her roses. It was already autumn, but the roses were still blooming. One day, she met a humorous man at a Thanksgiving festival. She fell in love with him. He made some game stew for her. She loved it. She felt safe with him. But his family didn't accept her, because she was just a middle-class girl. They had a secret relationship. One day, she showed him the newly decorated room. He got angry and told her to abort. That broke her heart, and she just wailed, "No!" He grabbed her by her hair and dragged her into the bathroom. He tried to drown her in the toilet. No one told her where to find the grave. She had to find this grave. She didn't find it. She tried to numb the pain with drugs. She often thought about suicide. But she couldn't believe that her child was dead. She continued her search. Then she found the place of the unwanted children. A brother and a sister got lost in the forest. Late at night, they finally found a house. The brother knocked on the door.
Who is knocking on my door?
The wind, the heaven-born wind.
Come inside, I have food for you. You won't have to suffer hunger anymore.
Inside the house, she locked the boy up in a cage. She forced the girl to check if the stove was already hot. The old woman pushed the girl into the oven. The boy had to eat the girl. Then she slaughtered the boy. The old woman kept her promise. The children didn't have to suffer hunger anymore. And if she hasn't died, she's still murdering today. Thank you. Nobody helped her. Everybody looked away. Was it all her fault? Over time, grief turned into anger. He lost faith in humanity. Her hate grew and grew. Revenge was the only thing she wanted. Everybody should feel the way she felt. Every night in her dreams, she took revenge on the villagers. Nobody could hurt her in her dream world. But this one night was a bit different. While she was trying to fall asleep, something was moving under her bed. She heard bone-breaking sounds. Someone scraped against her window. She began to dream. It was another dream of revenge. She stole a school bus. The school was her destination. Thank you. She wanted to kidnap all the children.
That's wrong.
First, she used gas to make everyone inside the building unconscious. She just had to collect the children. She could hear the darkness coming closer and closer. The darkness broke her soul.
Thank you.
She grabbed all the kids and went to the bus. Usually, this is the part in her dream when she wakes up. But it wasn't a dream this time. She could hear the children crying from the basement. How could she confuse reality with imagination? Ha ha. with all the children in the house, she somehow felt like a mother. This feeling warmed her up inside. But the children were afraid of her. A cruel plan was born of her madness.
Children, she would become one with them and their love.
She remembered the game stew's recipe. She went into the kitchen to prepare everything. She forgot the carrots in the basement. Now she could start cooking. She dreamed of a green meadow in summer. Children. Everyone was happy and satisfied. She was a great mother. Then she came back to reality. Only the meat was still missing. She took the children to a small cabin. Hugged all the children and told them that they didn't need to be afraid. she made the stew. The food was served. She ate the stew within several days. The villagers were looking for the children. No one suspected the female writer to be the perpetrator. From their point of view, a woman was just too weak. They were looking for a male paedophile. Desperate parents were calling for their children. Names echoed through the night. Now, everyone was feeling the way she felt. But that didn't make her feel better. She killed innocent children. Now, she was the village's biggest monster. She wanted to get the children back. But how do you do the impossible? Her madness created an illusion. She had to travel to the realm of the dead. But how was she to get there? She needed the ferryman's help. Can be paid with silver coins. he didn't appear. He needed more water to cross. This time. Maybe she could reverse her actions with this trip. This would also be her last chance to save her own soul. He drove her to the edge of hell. Fire was burning on her skin. She felt no pain. died a long time ago. Ferryman's help, she wanted to bring the children back to their parents. But that wasn't possible. Because she ate all the bodies. She promised the souls to find a way back to Earth. In the meantime, she brought the children to Limbo. Limbo was a magical place. It was both beautiful and scary at the same time. But she couldn't stay. She had to keep her promise. Her next destination was Hell. Was she back home yet? Was it all just a dream? No, unfortunately, it wasn't. She couldn't hear any sounds. She didn't feel anything. She didn't smell anything. It was her personal hell. absolute loneliness. Everything was dissolving. And suddenly, she couldn't see anymore. But she still had a mission. Suddenly, a small light began to shine in the distance. She ended up in a mystical forest. It was the forest of suicides. There are many reasons for such an act. It isn't a solution. It's an escape. Without return. Humans are complicated. They're good as well as evil. Only their decisions shape their characters. Without knowing loss, these words are easy to say. Look at the world. People hate each other or even themselves. For many different reasons. In the end, there are only losers. Sophia Red became such a loser. was taken from her, but she destroyed even more. A vicious cycle. She walked through the forest and found an exit. It was probably too late, but now she was trying to break the vicious cycle. She woke up in a hospital.
Doctor! She finally woke up! You tried to kill yourself in the bathtub. We know what you did to the children. Tell us where you buried the remains! She can't talk. Give her something to write. Come on, let's see if it's true.
Now we are alone. I am a nurse, and I am the mother of one of the children that you killed. I will kill you for that. But before I do that, I have to tell you something. After your child's father tried to drown you, we were able to save you and your child. They forced us to give them your child. We had to tell everyone that your child was dead. They wanted to kill the child, but they couldn't. They hid the child, and then they took it away. But now, you will never see your child again. Love can turn into hate. Hate generates hate. And the victims turn into perpetrators. An eternal cycle. Sophia didn't find a solution. She will never see the face of her own child. That's the biggest punishment. What would have happened if she had been looking for the corpse a little longer? But that would be a different story.